Sharing my glow up story. So if you haven't seen my growing up ugly video, that video is a lot more detailed on my glow up journey, and this video will be more so helping you and giving you tips on how to glow up personally, physically, and mentally. So I have made a list of 5 ways that I've leveled up and glowed up in my life, and I want to share it with you guys so you're able to apply this. So I want to start off by saying I wasn't always a really, really confident person. I actually used to be super, super insecure, and that just had to do with me not really meeting the beauty standards when I was younger. And it also had to do with my skin, and it just had to do with me constantly comparing myself to other people. I never really pushed myself to the limit that I should have been pushing myself to. And I just started to realize that me doing the bare minimum would never bring me to the place that I wanted to be at. I was also somebody who was really, really obsessed with being in a relationship and having somebody and just love. Like, I was just somebody who was so obsessed with being in love. And I was also somebody who lost myself in trying to find love. That kind of made me feel like it was my identity. Like, I felt like I was nobody if I didn't have love. I didn't really have career aspirations. I didn't really have goals. So this definitely led to me neglecting how I looked and neglecting my health. I wasn't my best during this time because I was just so worried about what other people around me were doing instead of worrying about what I could do in my own life to level up. So let's just go ahead and get started. Like I said, I'm not gonna go into full-blown detail just because I have another video that goes into way more detail than this video will go into, because I put a lot of work in that video, so you could check that out if you wanna know in detail. I've had acne since I was 12 years old, and it was a very, very major sense of insecurity for me. It was one of the things that made me super, super insecure. I was constantly comparing myself to people who had perfect skin, and it just made me feel really down because people would always say, yeah, you're attractive, but that acne makes you less attractive, or you would be more attractive if you didn't have all that acne. That was a constant thing in my life, and it was constantly people picking at me because I had really bad acne. That is definitely number one on my list. As soon as I cleared my acne, I felt more attractive, I felt healthier, I didn't resent looking at my face in the morning, I didn't pile pounds of makeup on my face to cover up my dark marks anymore. I was just finally clear. And if you have acne right now and you feel what I have felt in the past, I'm letting you know right now it is not permanent. Even though it feels like it's gonna be forever, it's not going to be forever. You are gonna find that thing that is going to clear you up. I have a whole entire playlist on my acne journey and the ways that I cleared it. So if you are really, really adamant on clearing your acne, I definitely suggest looking at those videos and just getting started with your journey. The next thing that I started doing was I started wearing makeup and clothes that fit me. Now, before, I would just be so scared to put on a really cute outfit, or I would be really, really scared to just like try to look my best because I just felt like I looked like a clown every time I did it. And my biggest advice for people who just kind of feel out of your comfort zone with putting on really cute makeup and just putting on like really cute clothes, just trying a new style out, the more that you do it, the more comfortable you will get with doing it. I know that it feels really uncomfortable, especially when your family has never seen you put on makeup, or if your family has never seen this new style, it can feel super, super uncomfortable. And I definitely suggest that you just do it. Just do it. Find yourself, find what fits you, and just run with it. Because if you never try anything, you'll never know what works for you. Because when I first started doing makeup, honey, I looked so bad. I did not look cute. I did not know what I was doing. I put on pounds of makeup because I was trying to cover up my dark marks, and I didn't know what I was doing. So you have to just learn on the way. You're not gonna know right off the bat. You're not gonna know what to do. You're not gonna know what foundation to pick. You have to experiment. So just get ready to experiment and find the thing that works personally for you. The next thing that helped me glow up was changing the people that I surrounded myself with. Now, I was not around the best influences. Sometimes I would be around people who were kind of envious of the things that I had, or I was just around people who just didn't really like me. They were just around me just to be around me, or they were just around me because they didn't have anybody else. So change your friends, okay? If you feel like you're around people who aren't the best influence, it's so important to get around those people who are the best influence. Now, it's great to have associates and it's great to have people that you just know, but as for the people that you spend your time around the most, they need to be top tier. I mean, these people need to be people who inspire you. Let's just give an example. So if you want to be around people who are more business minded, if you want to be around people who are thinking about their future rather than just thinking about in the now, you need to find those people. If you want to be around people who are entrepreneurs, if you want to be around people who are starting their own businesses and they're succeeding in it, befriend those people. Stop being friends with people who are doing the bare minimum and stop being friends with people with no motivation or drive, because if you're spending most of your time with those people, yeah, it's cool to be like friends with them and like do certain things with them because you always want to be friends with people from different walks of life. But if you're really serious about where you want to be in life, you want to surround yourself primarily around those people who you want to be like. Make sure that you're cutting off toxic friends, toxic boyfriends, girlfriends, or partners. Just make sure that you are stepping into the places that you want to be in, because when you constantly surround yourself by toxic people, that energy is affecting you and your personal life. Because I don't know about you, but I can become an overthinker when something is happening in my life that is really negative. I'll think about it all the time. It'll really affect me and my health, and I know that's a really common thing. So it's really hard and it's better said than done. But just think about just distancing yourself from these people and just cutting them out of your life, and you'll see that you will prosper even more. The next thing that I started doing that really helped me glow up was I got comfortable getting uncomfortable. So what do I mean by that? Basically, I mean that I forced myself out of my comfort zone a lot. Like, I mean a lot. And this could be applied to what I said about trying new makeup and outfits. You need to be comfortable with being uncomfortable, because the more that you're comfortable in your comfort zone, you're not gonna go anywhere. You're gonna be stagnant because you're gonna be like, oh, I don't wanna try this. I don't wanna try anything new because I don't know how people will act. I don't wanna try anything new because I'm not good at it. You have to get over that voice in your head and you need to just go for it. Don't let those negative thoughts hold you back. If anything, they should push you even more, because I would even say personally for myself, I was definitely at a point to where I was just in my head all the time. I was a dreamer. I just was in my head. I was like, one day I want to start YouTube. One day I want to do this. One day I want to start a business, but I don't know like what I would do. I don't know how I would start. And I was just in my head. I was just imagining all these awesome things that would happen if I did these things, and I would leave it at that. But something just snapped in me and I just realized, if I'm in my head all the time, how will I get stuff done? I won't. So I need to start doing things instead of just thinking that it's going to happen on its own. But that one thing that was once out of your comfort zone is now comfortable to you. So it's so important to just reach for the stars. You can accomplish anything that you put your mind to. The next thing that I did was study women who inspire me. Now, this is really important because you want to study people who you want to be like. These could be celebrities, these could be internet personalities, whatever the case may be, study them. Study what you like about them. Now, this doesn't necessarily say, oh my God, copy them, do everything they do. No, take certain aspects of what they do that you enjoy and apply it to yourself in a way that's unique for you. So for example, if you see somebody who's a celebrity and you're like, oh, I really, really love the way they dress. I wish I could dress like that. If I dress like that, I feel like it would really complement my shape or my appearance. Definitely try to do that. Try to mock it in a way that's still unique for yourself, but it still looks good on you, because a lot of times the way somebody dresses or acts, it does only look good on them, but you can mix it up in a way to where it fits you. Or even if you love the way somebody articulates themselves, or if you like that somebody speaks really clearly, anything like that, watch what that person does, watch what they say, start listening to more people who kind of embody the kind of tone you want to have in your voice, who embody the way you want to do your hair, anything that you want to embody, watch those people more often, because the more that you watch something, the more that you soak it in, because the more that you expose yourself to something, the more that you act like it. That's why they say birds of a feather flock together. That's why they say pay attention to what you watch and what you read, because you really do act similar to those things that you ingest the most. For me, for instance, I really, really love listening to really, really motivational bloggers. I really love watching YouTubers that inspire me and YouTubers that I want to be like one day. And I think that's so important for people who need a role model, because it's really good to follow into somebody else's footsteps before you can really plan out who you are individually. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up. It really, really helps to support this channel. I love you guys so much. Please comment down below what you think. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.